Here's a quick video of the Monitor Audio Radius 360 compact subwoofer 8-inch breaking up. So I managed to purchase this sub, which was fairly decent, had a few chips and nicks on it, but the subwoofer's blown. Thought I'll make a project out of it, but nevertheless I thought I'll show you a quick video of the breaking up. Camera's coming out of focus there a little bit. Anyway, so as you can see, it's got a little blue light in the front that shows you when it's operational. I've unplugged it, so you're not going to see that working. Just to give you an idea of what you're going to get when you look at the back of the unit itself, you've got quite a decent plate amp. There we go, Monitor Audio Radius 360. I've just taken the time to prepare this, remove the screws already as it is. As you can see, it's got the switchable voltage, on-off power switch, typical kettle power connector. You've got your speaker outputs for your stereo, just to send through the low frequency sounds through to it. Frequency knobs, volume knobs, left-right input, phase switches, and this one very nicely has settings for both music and movies. Now, if you look at the bottom of the unit itself, that's usually where the sub would sit, and you see the power port, base port at the bottom, and that's the subwoofer that comes with it. Fairly decent value, nice polymer cone, large dust cap, rubber butyl sort of surround, very good frequency, movement and excursion on the sub itself. That's what the sub looks like at the back. Not a lot of branding on it, but nevertheless, connection looks like a paper mulch type of cone material. But more importantly, let's look what the sub looks like on the inside. So it's got some foam packaging. That's the connections for the speaker itself. You would connect to the speaker. And the port itself, as you can see, it's just one single port. And it's got this little baffle on the inside that goes all the way to the end, and with a gap at the back end. So not the best designs in that way, or thought process, I would have thought. That's how the sub and the plate fits into the back. I'll just give you a quick look at what the plate amp looks like. There we go. I mean, generally, it looks like the box is made out of MDF, probably 15 mils. That's the finish on the inside. Apologies for this not being as clear as it could be. Like I said, I've got some focusing issues with my camera at the moment. There we go. That's a bit clearer. But there wasn't a lot of foam packing on the inside. It was just that piece and that stuff and towards the back end of it. But that's about all, the only type of dampening material it had. And that's the plate amp. Not sure if you can make out what these ICs look like. Nothing too special. Power transformer. And there we go. Monitor Audio.